Hello friends, welcome to 2thepoint. In this session, we are discussing about surds and indices. So what is a surds and indices? A surd is said to be, a surd is an illogical number expressed with a root. An indices means the power to the surds or any other number, it is called indices. Indices is a plural form of index. Example of surds. When we can't simplify a number to remove its square root or cube root, then it is called as surd. For example, say square root of 2. It cannot be simplified further, so it is called a surd. And the other example is square root of 4. It can be simplified further. If it is simplified, we get 2. And this is not a surd. Now let's learn the laws of indices. A power m into a power n is equals to a to the power of m plus n. This can be written so because bases are same. And a power m divided by a power n can be written as a to the power of m minus n. Here also the bases are same. So if bases are same, we can use this laws. And a power m whole to the power of n is equals to a to the power of m into n. And a into b whole to the power of n is equals to a power n into b power n. A by b whole to the power of n is equals to a power n divided by b power n. And we know that any number with the power 0 is equals to 1. Now let's discuss about laws of surds. N root of a is equals to a to the power of 1 by n. And n root of a into b can be written as n into square root of a into n into square root of b. And next, n root of a by b is equals to n root a divided by n root b. N root a whole power n is equals to 8 to the power of 1 by n and whole to the power of n. And this can further be written as a into 1 by n into n, where n and n get cancels. We are left out with a. In order to solve the problems on surds and indices, remember all these laws. Surds and indices completely depends on simplification. So in surds and indices, you'll have the questions depending on simplification. First, simplify 81 to the power of 3 by 4. Divide 81. 3 27s are 81 and 3 9s are 27 and 3 3s are 9. With this, we are left out with 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 is equals to 81, which indicates that 3 to the power of 4 is equals to 81. Substitute this value in the question. We get 3 to the power of 4 and whole to the power of 3 by 4, which can be written as 3 to the power of 4 multiplied by 3 by 4. 4 and 4 get cancels and we are left out with 3 cube, which is nothing but 27. Therefore, 81 to the power of 3 by 4 is 27. Simplify 1024 to the power of minus 4 by 5. We know 1024 is equals to 4 to the power of 5. So this can be written as 4 to the power of 5 and whole to the power of minus 4 by 5. So 4 to the power of 5 multiplied by minus 4 by 5. 5 and 5 gets cancelled and we are left out with 4 to the power of minus 4. And this can be written as 1 by 4 to the power of 4, which is equals to 1 by 256. Simplify 0.0016 to the power of 3 by 4. This can be written as 16 divided by 1000 to the power of 3 by 4. And we know 16 is nothing but 2 to the power of 4 and 10,000 is 10 to the power of 4. Now simplify this, we get 2 by 10 to the power of 4 into 3 by 4. 4 and 4 get cancels and 2 ones are 2 fives are, which is equals to 1 by 5 whole to the power of 3, which is equals to 1 by 125. Simplify 17 to the power of 3.5 into 17 to the power of x is equals to 17 to the power of 8. Here, find the value of x. So we know a power m into a power n is equals to a to the power of m plus n. So using this formula, substitute the values, you get 17 to the power of 3.5 plus x is equals to 17 to the power of 8. So as the bases are same, consider only the powers. 3.5 plus x is equals to 8. Now find the value of x. X is equals to 4.5. A by b to the power of x minus 1 is equals to b by a to the power of x minus 3. Have to find the value of x. It is given a by b to the power of x minus 1 is equals to b by a to the power of x minus 3. So we know 1 by x to the power of n can be written as x to the power of minus n. So using this, we can solve this. A by b to the power of x minus 1 is equals to a by b to the power of minus of x minus 3. So here bases are same. Again take only the powers. X minus 1 is equals to minus of x minus 3. Find the value for x. You get x minus 1 is equals to 3 minus x. So 2x is equals to 4 and the value of x is equals to 2. If 10 to the power of 0.48 is equals to x and 10 to the power of 0.70 is equals to y, then find the value of z for x to the power of z is equals to y square. We had to find the value for x power z is equals to y square. It is given that the value of x is equals to 10 to the power of 0.48 and whole to the power of z, which is equals to, and y. The value of y is 10 to the power of 0.70 whole to the power 2. Now simplify this equation. We get 10 to the power of 0.48 into z is equals to 10 to the power of 0.70 into 2. As the bases are same, consider only the powers. 0.48 into z is equals to 0.70 into 2. Now solve for z. We get z is equals to 0.70 into 2 divided by 0.48, which is equals to 35 by 12, which can also be written as 2.9. If 5 power a is equals to 3125, then find the value of 5 power a minus 3. 5 power a is equals to 3125. Here simplify 3125. 3125 divided by 5 gives 625 and further divided by 5 gives 125. And 5 25s are 125 and 5 5s are 25. So by this we can say that 5 to the power of 5 is equals to 3125. So 5 power a is equals to 5 power 5. As the bases are same, equate it, we get a's value as 5. So if a's value is 5, 5a minus 3, the value of 5a minus 3 is 5 to the power of 5 minus 3, which is equals to 5 square. Therefore, the value of 5 to the power of a minus 3 is equals to 25. If 3 to the power of x minus y is equals to 27 and 3 to the power of x plus y is equals to 243, then find the value of x. It is given that 3 to the power of x minus y is equals to 27, and 27 can be written as 3 to the power of 3, and 3 to the power of x plus y is equals to 243. This 243 can be written as 3 to the power of 5. So as the bases are same, equate the equation. X minus y is equals to 3 and x plus y is equals to 5. If you add this, you get 2x is equals to 8, and therefore the value of x is 4. Simplify the expression. 1 by 1 plus x to the power of b minus a plus x to the power of c minus a plus 1 by 1 plus x to the power of a minus b plus x to the power of c minus b plus 1 by 1 plus x to the power of b minus c plus x to the power of a minus c. Using a power m minus n is equals to a to the power of m and a to the power of n, we can solve this equation. We get 1 by 1 plus x to the power of b by x to the power of a plus x to the power of c by x to the power of a plus 1 by 1 plus x to the power of a divided by x to the power of b plus x to the power of c by x to the power of b. Similarly solve for the other term and simplify. You get x power a divided by x power a plus x power b plus x power c plus x power b divided by x power a plus x power b plus x power c plus and x power c divided by x power a plus x power b plus x power c. Adding all this, you get x power a plus x power b plus x power c divided by x power a plus x power b plus x power c. This both get cancelled out as it is the same term and you are left out with 1. Simplify and find the value of n for the following. 243 to the power of n by 5 multiplied by 3 to the power of 2n plus 1 divided by 9 to the power of n into 3 to the power of n minus 1. So 243 is 3 to the power of 5 whole to the power of n by 5 into 3 to the power of 2n plus 1 divided by 9 to the power of n into 3 to the power of n minus 1. Here 5 and 5 get cancels and now the equation becomes 3 to the power of n into 3 to the power of 2n plus 1 divided by 3 to the power of 2n into 3 to the power of n minus 1. Here the bases are same, so now you can write it as 3 to the power of n plus 2n plus 1 divided by 3 to the power of 2n plus n minus 1, which is equals to 3 to the power of 3n plus 1 divided by 3 to the power of 3n minus 1. And further simplification gives you 3 to the power of 3n plus 1 minus 3n minus 1, which is equals to 3 square. The value of 3 square is 9. See you in the next session. Thank you.